Hello students, today's video is for BBA third year finance specialization student, and we will discuss the subject called WCM, that is working capital management. Dear students, till now we have studied in unit 2 the various concepts of cash management. We have also seen the significance, the factors which determines the cash budget, the approaches to cash management. In today's video, we will discuss another major aspect of cash management. So in today's video, we will see the various methods of cash forecast. Now the meaning of cash forecast. What is cash forecast? Dear students, cash forecast is always made on various tentative, or you may say speculative, events. Speculative events. Cash management or the cash forecast may be made for long term, or you may say short term forecasts.
So dear students, cash forecast is nothing but it is a forecast of various specific or periodic events that whether in the future what is the amount of cash that is required so that the business can take various necessary steps accordingly. So for this purpose, cash forecast is always prepared.
It is made on always specific events.
So various speculative events are considered while managing the cash forecast. So under cash forecast, what the managers see, the managers generally forecast that what is the amount of cash that is required for managing the funds, for managing the business. So for this purpose, that the business should not face any kind of problem on a future date, generally cash forecast is being prepared.
Then the next point says us, it may be prepared for the purpose of long term or short term basis. Depending upon the size of the business, generally the cash budget is prepared. It may be prepared for short term purposes, it may be prepared for long term purposes. Depending upon the size and nature of the business, generally cash forecast is being prepared. So all depends upon whether the business is having long term operations, whether the business is having short term operations. Depending upon that, the cash budget is prepared.
So the next point tells us that it is concerned with anticipated events. So under cash forecast, we always consider certain events that must be anticipated. It means it depends upon the judgment capability of the cash manager. The cash manager has to judge accordingly that what is the amount of cash that is required on a future date, so that accordingly he or she, it means the cash manager, can accordingly take various necessary actions as per to the requirement.
Now cash forecast always results in planning. Cash forecast is generally made for the purpose of planning only. We generally prepare the cash budget for the purpose of better planning, so that there will not be any kind of cash shortage on the future dates. So whenever there is the requirement of cash is there, the business must be capable enough to maintain proper amount of cash, so that the business never faces any kind of problems so far as the cash is concerned. Because dear students, cash is always been considered as a vital part of a business. Without cash, no business can survive. It's a true fact that without cash, no business can survive. Irrespective of the size of the organization, maybe large scale unit, maybe medium scale unit, or maybe a small scale unit, all the business requires some amount of cash at every point of time. So it is quite necessary to hold sufficient amount of cash. How to hold sufficient amount of cash? How to make efficient use of our cash so that in a future the business will not face any kind of cash related problems? For this purpose, the cash forecasting or the concept of cash forecasting came into existence. So it is very necessary for us to go through in a detailed manner what are the various methods of today's topic is methods of cash forecast. So what are the various methods of cash forecast that must be considered while preparing the cash management process. So it is nothing but a part of the cash management process. So it always results in the planning. It is the inherent quality of the cash manager that the cash managers must able to take various necessary steps so that on a future the business will not face any kind of problems. Now it is always concerned with specific business functions. Since cash is related to the finance, so
it forms only a part of finance function only. We can say cash forecast is always related to the cash functions only or any specific business function only.
It does not act as a tool for controlling the measurement.
So cash forecast cannot be used as a tool for controlling the cash. So under cash forecasting, just we are making a forecast or an analysis that what is the amount of cash that is required on a future date. But cash forecast does not help us for controlling the cash. So for this purpose, we develop another concept that is nothing but called as cash budget. Very important topic, cash budget. So cash budget forms one of the, you can say, one of the method of cash forecasting. There is not a huge difference between cash forecast and a cash budget. Cash budget forms a part of cash forecast only. So for better understanding of the cash forecasting methods, it is quite necessary for us to go through the cash budget process. So we will start now the cash budget. What is cash budget? क्या है ये cash budget? See, the business organization is having so many activities like sales activity, like production activity. So like that, cash is another activity. So for the better management of cash, it is also very much essential that we must hold or we must keep a separate cash budget also. The business organization at every point of time prepare sales budget, prepare production budget. So like that, a separate cash budget is also required to be prepared for managing the cash in a very efficient manner. So for the better management of cash, we must prepare a cash budget separately so that the controlling of cash can easily be possible. So under cash budget, we always consider two things. Under cash budget, we always consider two things only. Number one, cash inflow. Number two, cash outflow. Cash inflow and cash outflows are always considered in cash budget. If we have a better concept or we are having very clear idea regarding which cash inflows as well as regarding the cash outflows, then definitely preparation of cash budget will not be a great issue. We can easily able to prepare the cash budget. Now under cash budget, we include certain things like production activities. So under production activities, for the point of view of cash budget or from cash budget point of view, the activities of production which are related to material, which are related to labor, and which are related to various overhead expenses are only considered. because under material, labor and overhead we need to pay cash. So when there is the concept of cash, that should be included in the cash budget. Similarly, in the production process also, whatever the amount that is required for purchase of materials, what is the amount that is required for payment of wages to laborers, what is the amount of expenses that should be incurred for other expenses or for overhead expenses. So only these items will be considered in cash budget. Then any other activities which related to cash, maybe payment of income tax, payment of interest, payment of dividend to the shareholders. So when there is any activity related to cash, maybe inflow or maybe outflow, maybe cash receipts, maybe cash payments. So all the inflows, all the outflows of cash activity, if there is certain amount of cash is associated in the transaction, then that transaction forms a part of the cash budget. That transaction forms a part of the cash budget. When there is the amount of cash or any amount of cash which is related to the inflow or outflow of cash, that should be considered under cash budget. Now let's discuss the meaning of cash budget in a more detailed manner. required for a fixed period of time only. So with the help of cash budget, we can easily able to estimate that whether in a future date whether there will be cash requirement or not, or if on a future date there will be unnecessary blockage of cash or not, because both things lead to mismanagement. We have also seen under approaches to cash management that we should hold sufficient amount of cash for the purpose of maximizing the profit. So for a particular moment, we may also say that we should keep sufficient amount of cash, or we should keep optimum amount of cash so that it will be very, very fruitful to our organization. Now, cash budget always helps us to know whether on a future date there will be cash requirement or not, and accordingly the cash budget will function its activities. Now, talking about some of the meanings, cash budget is related to planned events only. As I said right now, that with the help of cash budget, we are making an proper estimation whether the cash is properly required or not, whether how much cash should be required on a future date, how much cash we should keep with ourselves so that there will not be any unnecessary blockage of the cash. So it is always done in a very planned manner. A cash budget is a target fixed for a specific period. Cash budget is nothing but it is a target which is fixed generally for a period. It means we generally prepare cash budget for a period of 3 months, 4 months, or maximum of 5 to 7 months only. And accordingly, we determine that whether our cash requirement will be in a shortage position or not. Why this is needed? Technically speaking, see, if we will not prepare a cash budget and on a future date there is high urgency of cash. Now, when we immediately arrange for cash, then the cost for arranging the cash will be definitely higher. We have to definitely look hurry forward for arrangement of cash, which may lead to high amount of interest. Now, the same thing, if we know that on a future date there will be cash shortage, so from today onwards we will start arranging for the cash requirement that will be fulfilled while the cash shortage is there. So if we make various advance preparation, then our arrangement for cash will not be a costly affair. Rather, we can easily able to afford the cash, or we can easily able to arrange the cash with very low amount of cost. Now, results of the financial planning is nothing but the cash budget. In other words, we may also say that cash budget is nothing but it is the results of the financial planning. So with the help of cash budget, we always help to prepare the financial planning. So with the help of cash budget, the financial planning of the organization automatically be fulfilled. Cash management always helps the organization in various financial planning as well as various financial decision making. So with the help of cash budget, we can easily able to prepare the financial plannings. The next point, the process of cash budget starts when the process of cash forecast ends. So in some other words, we may also say the process of cash budget starts when the cash forecast, or the process of cash forecast ends, ENDS. So cash budget is the advanced stage of cash forecasting. When the process of cash forecasting ends, then the process of cash budget starts. Cash budget is the advanced stage of cash forecasting, which is generally being prepared for a short period of time. Later on we will discuss that.
So cash budget always helps to determine the operating cash requirements for proper cash planning and control. So cash budget always helps the organization to determine the operating cash requirements. Dear students, every organization should determine or should try to determine what is the operating cash requirements. Because only when we fix up the operating cash requirements, then only we can properly able to hold the optimum amount of cash. So the operating cash requirements should be clearly determined, and with the help of a cash budget, we are always try to prepare the optimum operating cash requirement. Another thing is that the operating cash requirements always helps for proper cash planning and control. So with the help of operating cash requirement, the cash planning and cash requirement automatically be fulfilled. The cash planning as well as the cash control can easily be fulfilled with the help of a cash budget. So if we have a proper cash budget, then our operating cash requirement, cash planning, cash forecast, cash control, all these things is easily possible with the help of the cash budget. For the last point, it is always prepared for a short period of time. Generally we seen that cash forecast is prepared maybe for a long period or maybe for a short period. But the concept of cash budget that right now we are discussing, cash budget is always prepared for a short period of time only. So the basic objective of cash budget is that we should prepare the cash budget so that on a future date there will not be any cash shortage, neither there will be unnecessary blockage of cash. Because if there will be unnecessary blockage of cash, then also it will not be fruitful for the organization. Rather, in that case, we may look forward various investment of the additional cash in various marketable securities, which can be easily converted into cash within a short period of time. So cash budget is always helpful to the organization for maintaining proper or optimum cash balance. That's it in today's video.